In this video, we'll create a carousel in just 3 simple steps using auto layout and variants, and I will share with you what plugin I use for images. Let's go to Figma. Alright, so the first thing we need to do is to create our new frame that will be our movie car. So I will hit F to select the frame and quickly draw here a frame. And we can go here to the right hand side and set the width to 200 and the height to 300. Then I will set the fill from white to black, just like so, and create a new text frame. So I will type here movie title, hit shift A to apply auto layout and move it inside of our card, just like so. Change the color to white, align to left, and we can set the horizontal padding to 16, just like so. And now we need a picture to add into our card. So with our frame selector, go here to plugins, and usually I use the Unsplash plugin, which gave us free images from their stock site. So I'm already logged in into this plugin, and for this card I will use this car right here. It automatically applies into our frame, and here to get more readability into our title, we can go here to fill and add a gradient fill to our image. So now it's solid, I want it to be gradient, and let's switch here the orientation, just like that, and I can set the opacity to 50%, so now it's more darker here. So we have now our first car. We will hit command D to add 2 more for our carousel, and we will do the same with the images. So I will select the frame 2, and I will select this image. Then I can select the frame 3, and I will apply this image. Now let's add some names to our movies. So the first one will be driving lights, the second one the bridge train, that sounds like an horror movie, and this one can be underground. Okay, now we should also rename the frames here on top, because this will help us in the next video that we will use variables, backgrounds while changing from card to card, but that will be in another video. I think it's always good to have our layers renamed, because if you have a big project, you can keep it organized. So you have now 3 movie cards, pretty nice. So next step is to create our component and its variants before prototyping. So right now we don't have any hierarchy in our cards, we don't know what is selected or highlighted, so let's go to that. First select all frames and hit shift A to apply auto layout, and here on top let's create a component from this. And we can rename this frame 3 to carousel. Okay, so now if you click and drag here, nothing happens. And this is because we didn't set any auto layout restrictions to our cards, so they don't resize when we do this. But if you want to know more about auto layout, check the video in the description where I explain all the steps to create responsive components. Okay. Now I want that when I start my prototype, the driving lights movie will be wider than the other 2. So I need to set the horizontal size of this card. So double click here to have this frame selected. And I want to that this horizontal resizing become fill container. And as you can notice, it already changed this. So if I now shrink or expand, it's already happening something to my driving lights card. Okay, but I don't want to increase all over the place to something like that. I want that at the moment it gets 360, it should not increase more. So I will click here again to select it, And here in the width, I will have the maximum width to 360. So now if I click in the carousel and expand it, as you can see, it will not expand anymore because it's blocked. We set the restrictions to this width. And we don't need to change the others because they are already fixed at 200. That was the size that we applied in the beginning. Okay, so now we are starting to get some hierarchy here. We see that this one is bigger than this one, but we can add another level here of hierarchy. So, for example, what we can do is to select here the image of the train and go here to opacity and set to 50%. And the same here, we can set the underground image to 50%. And now we have more relevance here on our driving lights card compared to these two images. Okay, so now let's add our variant. We can click here on this plus icon on top and we have two variants of our carousel. But before we edit the second variant, we can go here to the right hand side of this settings panel and we can call this property selected movie. And the variant can be driving lights. And the second variant will be the bridge train. So now what we need to do is to select the driving lights and instead of fill, it should be fixed width and we should set this to 200 and also set the opacity to 50% because now we will not be selected. The one that will be selected, it will be the bridge train. So change the fill of the image to 100% and set the fill container with max width 360. So I think you are getting the point. So now let's add another variant, hit here in the plus icon, and we will do the same for the underground image. So here, let's set the fixed width to 200, lower the opacity to 50%. And now in this one, let's make it fill container and add max width to 360. Okay, pretty cool. So now we have our three variants of our carousel. Just let me quickly change here the opacity of the image to 100%. And now let's change also here the name of our variant to the name of the movie underground. And there you go. You have now your component set and variants created. So you are ready for the third and last step, prototyping. So head over to the right hand side and switch to prototype and let's start linking and animating our cards. So first double click here in the bridge train and here in this plus icon you can click and drag to the expanded bridge train. So what it means is that when I click here it will go to this variant that will show our bridge train expanded. And what I want is that on click, I want to change the selected movie to the bridge. And I want this as a smart animate. And the animation I want is to be gentle and we can keep it at 800 milliseconds. And we will do the same for the other collapsed images. So here, this one goes to underground. As you can see, the settings are already the same. But pay attention in your case to check if it's already there. Then the driving lights goes on top. And here the same. And then this bridge train here. And this one here. And I think we cover everything. So let's quickly draw here a playground area. So hit F. Then quickly draw here a playground, we can call it playground, switch here to design so that I can set the fill here to black and go here to assets and here we have our carousel component that we can place here and let's test it. Okay, so now we have here our driving lights that we can see that it's currently selected. Now if I click it expands, collapse this one, and it make it brighter also. Then if we click in the underground, the same happen. And there you go. Okay, now you can also ask, pretty cool Ricardo, but what if I want to add one or more cards to this selection? How can I do it? Well, it's easy, let's do it right now. Cool bonus for you, right? So head back to our carousel component, switch back from prototype to design, and go here to our carousel component. Let's expand here our frame because we will need some space. Okay, just like so. And we can also expand our variants. It could be helpful. And here, for example, let's select this underground item and we can hit Command D to duplicate them. And now again, go to our plugin and splash to switch the images. So here I can put this one, and for that one, I can use this. And let's rename our movie. So this can be in the code, something like that. And here can be wired, could be. Okay, let me close. So we have now our two new cards. And what we can do also, since this is already the auto layout applied, we can hit Command C to copy, select the second variant and add them here. And there you have it. So now you have a carousel with 5 images, but we are missing one thing. We now need to create the expanded or selected version for in the code and wired movie cards. So what we need to do is to go select the last variant, add a new one that we can call it in the code. And it's just simply do the same as we have done before. So here we can set the opacity of in the code to 100%. This one will be 50% again because it will not be highlighted, and we need to change the fixed width to 200, and this one will be into fill container. Add max width 360. Perfect. And now the last one for the wired, we will do the same. So here we can decrease the opacity, set the fixed width to 200, and the wired, let's put 100%, and fill container to 360. Okay, and regarding design, we have all our variants prepared. So now we just need to link our prototype. So go again here, and here in the code we need to delete this because it gets the same linking from the underground, which was the card that we duplicated. So what we need to do is click here and go here and delete these linkings. I will quickly do that. Okay, so I think the linking is pretty much done. So let's go again to our playground. Now we need to increase the size of our playground area because we have more components, and we just need to run it again. And now let's test it. So driving lights, the bridge train, underground in the code, and wired. And you can click randomly on each other, that will work. And there you go. So the carousel is working well. In the upcoming videos, we will use this with variables and background images, like it was for a neural section for Netflix, for example. Do you want it to know how you can do it? So I hope you enjoyed the video. Leave your like and comment in the box below if it was helpful for you. Thank you and have a great day.